It's more planting we want, but trees, not lots of lawn. That's a message from researchers who are urging a rethink on how our green spaces are managed, and that includes your backyard. Kim Baker-Wilson explains why.
A weekend ritual, and one some say no longer makes the cut.
It all came about because of climate change, and most people don't really understand just how bad it's going to get.
This, he says, can help. Digging up well-kept lawns at home and on public land, and putting in trees.
And we need to be planting it. I mean, we've got to cut emissions, that's critical.
But what's wrong with the humble lawn?
Well, the type of mower and how often it's used does come into play. But this research also says once lawn is watered and once lawn is fertilised, over time, these patches of green grass are only adding to our greenhouse gas emissions.
Even if we planted just a third of the mowing grass in cities around the world, we can absorb 6,000 million tonnes of carbon dioxide over two decades.
Auckland Council's 100% into that idea. We can't tell people what to do in their own backyards.
But it can encourage.
Retaining trees and planting more trees on private property is as important as council's role of planting trees on council land.
And on council land, the research calls for more there too.
Here we've got a low-mow trial where we have taken areas of reserve grass out of the mowing schedule. Instead it gets mowed twice a year, once in the late summer and then early spring.
But is it enough?
They need to take a much bigger lead, and this is local government throughout the world.
Everyone here agrees lawns are a leftover from the past.
It's time we start to look to change that and look towards what does actually a New Zealand backyard look like.
The future is what's important now. Kim Baker-Wilson, One News.